Welcome. My name is John Hiskin. I'm the Health and Physical Education Consultant at the Department of Public Instruction, and we are going to model the second edition of our Suicide Prevention Units of Instruction, grades 6 through 8, or grades 8 through 10. I'm going to primarily focus on the grades 8 through 10 curriculum, and then show the connections to the younger age in this presentation. We have three of my co-workers here to help me present, and they're going to briefly introduce themselves to you, and we'll start on my left.
Hi, I'm Mark Prudenberg.
Hi, I'm Randy Field.
Hi, I'm Julie Incity.
Each of these lessons that we're going to be doing consists of four different unique types of lessons. The first type, as we move on to the next slide, we'll be focusing in on an engagement lesson. And we really have two of the intro engagement lessons that one we're going to model and one we're going to briefly talk about in this presentation. There's a content lesson that we will be doing after that, and then a skill-based lesson, and we'll have some discussion of the review games that are in both of the curricula, and each of us will model a middle and a high school assessment lesson that is in the unit of instruction. Next slide. The first lesson that we are going to be modeling is a database lesson. It's in both, they're done differently, but they're in both units of instruction. We're going to do the high school one, and each of my co-workers have been asked to answer five questions that are in the high school data lesson. And they deal with the issues of depression, planning, and acting on a potential suicide attempt. And I'm just going to ask them, they answered these questions previous to coming to the beginning of this presentation. And I'm going to ask, how many out of five did they overestimate the risk for? Mark, would you start first?
Yeah, I overestimated one.
So one out of five, Mark overestimated the risk by at least 5%. Julie, would you tell me how many you overestimate?
Sure. I also overestimated by one, on one.
And Randy, could you tell me how many you overestimate?
Well, unfortunately, I overestimated all five.
Research on this particular issue says your, in terms of a lot of health issues, we tend to overestimate risk, both our students that we teach as well as the adults, except in this one area. And that's in the area of mental health related issues. So I wasn't really terribly surprised to see Mark and Julie have very low numbers. I was a little bit surprised that Randy had five, but that's okay. Everybody responds a little bit differently based on their experiences, based on the things that they've heard. It's very common to have a few people that overestimate this risk in this mental health area. But it kind of sets the stage for what we're going to do in the next engagement lesson. In the middle school, we have a set of data lessons as points too. And the one that we want to emphasize at middle school is that when middle school students plan for a suicide attempt, they're very likely to complete it. It's almost 95% if they reach the point where they've written down that they've planned a suicide attempt, that they actually do attempt it. So that's a message that we want to say, is that middle school students will act on their thought process. So that's the first engagement lesson. The second engagement lesson, if you would click the, is the use of DVDs to set the stage. And we used two DVDs depending on whether you're doing the middle or the high school curriculum. They're called SOS Get Into the Act, which is the middle school unit of instruction DVD, and Friends for Life, which is the brand new 2011 high school version. And what we have our students doing in both of these lessons that we will not be modeling today is, one, they see four different scenarios, three for the middle school and four for the high school. And what each of them are going to be, would be assigned to do, is they would be in charge of looking at one of the scenarios. Mark might be looking into the high school student that's trying to get into college. Randy might be doing the one where the brother is trying to help a sister who seems like she's depressed. And Julie might choose the scenario where a high school boy is being bullied. And they have two tasks. One is, what warning signs do they see in these vignettes? And two, did the person that was listening to this information apply the major skill that we want to apply in this curriculum? That's ACT. Acknowledge that your friend or the person that you're dealing with is having a problem. Show care, which is the C, and concern for that individual. And then T, the most important, is to be able to tell somebody who can make a difference in this. So we want every student that walks out of this unit of instruction knowing warning signs as content and knowing how to practice the skill of ACT, acknowledge, care, tell. With that in mind, we're going to move, if we can press to the next one. And by the way, before I forget, each of these two DVDs are available at every one of the CESAs in the state of Wisconsin. So you can reserve them and use them themselves if you choose not to purchase your own for your school district. Moving on to our first of our content lessons, we're going to be modeling the lesson called Phone Booth. And in Phone Booth, we've developed scenarios that students have to listen for the warning signs that are being presented in the scenarios. We have some for the middle school level. We're going to be doing a high school one today on a call to a suicide hotline. And we also have ones, if you really become interested, in other areas, some of the more sensitive areas in health education. We're more than willing to send those to you if you're interested by contacting me at the end of this presentation. What we're doing here is Julie and Randy will be reading the scenario. Randy will be the person at the suicide hotline. Julie will take on the role of Sam, who is calling that hotline. And Mark is going to be listening for two things. One, this is to practice the major warning signs that are out there and are evidence-based. And many of them are connected to the four areas that I'm briefly going to discuss. Feelings, actions, changes that the person may go through, and threats that the person may make. The acronym FACT is an easy way to remember this. Mark is going to be listening for mainly feelings, but he's also going to be listening for any behaviors discussed that are urgent in nature. And if that's the case, then we're going to have to discuss whether, in this case, Pat, the person that Randy is playing, did things properly in this call to the suicide hotline. We'll begin now with the call. Ring.
Hello, this is the Wellview County Hotline. How can I help you?
My boyfriend left me today, and my life is not worth living.
It seems like you were really close with him.
He was my soulmate. Ever since I lost my parents in an auto accident last year, he has been my best friend. And then Terry came on the scene.
I'm very concerned about you at this time.
This is not the first time I have thought about this. When I was in college, I took an overdose and nearly died. But my life has gone well for the last 5 years. I'm happy with the treatment I received, and my family was real supportive when I lost my job last year.
I think we need to talk further about your life. Can you come to the health center?
Yes, but it will have to be tomorrow because I'm just exhausted after this day.
I want you to come in the office building first thing tomorrow. Promise me you'll be there. Can I tell a family member about my concern for you?
Not at this time, but I promise not to do anything. And thanks for your concern.
That was a minute and a half scenario, and we now turn it over to Mark, who is listening for feelings and any other observations that he observed in listening to the scenario.
Well, initially, the feelings, under the feelings category, the feelings of hopelessness, helplessness, worthless, also actions considering recent losses such as death, divorce, relationship, job status, or self-esteem. Also, she dealt with a threat, kind of talking about suicide from overdose a few years before that. So it seemed there were some major concerns in that she had lost her parents, had overdosed before, and lost her job recently.
Based on that, Mark, would you say that this is a person that needed immediate assistance?
Yes.
So it was urgent enough for you as the observer of the warning signs to say that this was a major problem.
Yep.
If we put this lesson to the complete test, we'd ultimately have probably checked off 8 warning signs, of at least 1 or 2 being urgent, of the urgent variety. And urgent means immediate care for this particular person. Now, well, let's talk a little bit about Pat's behavior on the suicide hotline. Julie, do you think that he showed some care and concern for you?
I think he did.
So he acknowledged that you had a problem?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And were you troubled at all by anything he decided to do in this? Because you made the call.
Yeah, well, I was concerned at the end that he was willing to put this off until the next day. I thought it needed immediate attention.
Okay, and that's what we would find in our discussion. This scenario was established to show that in cases like this, where there's that many warning signs and at least 1 to 2 urgent warning signs, this is a person that needed immediate assistance. Okay, and in the middle school one, we have some middle school appropriate scenarios as well for this particular lesson. This is called phone booth, and it's a content-based lesson. Can we go to the next slide, please? In the next slide, this is a combination of practicing what you learned in terms of content and applying it to the skill of acknowledge, care, tell. There are 3 rules in this particular lesson. Each group of students would be normally given about 8 to 9 pictures. And we're going to kind of be modeling this today, and we're going to be holding up the pictures, and I'm going to model the story because of time limitations. And I put together a story that one of the requirements in the rubric is that the main character has a name. In this case, the name is James. And James, in this particular case, has been kind of noticeably sad in school. And people are noticing it. And the reason James is always sad is because his dad is constantly angry at him and is constantly picking on him. And if he doesn't achieve well, do well enough in school, he is immediately looked down upon. So dad is a very angry person. James's ship is sinking. His life around him seems to be crumbling. And he developed kind of a really low interest in a lot of things, especially in his grades at school. Any C that he received first semester became a D or an F during the second semester. His friends are always notice this and are talking about it, and they decide we need to do something. James looks like he could be in big trouble. So he contacts Miss Wilson, school counselor, and said to her, we need to help James. I'm worried that he could do something serious to himself. And so Mrs. Wilson developed an intervention. And the intervention included members of his family, including Dad, who he wasn't getting along with. And Dad really realized he wasn't handling this very well, and acknowledged that he could be a better parent in this. So they all decided to show some care and concern for James, and his life turned around. This is lights, camera, action. Students love this, and they are very adept at putting together stories that model the messages that we are sharing today with you in terms of acknowledge, care, and tell. Lights, camera, action. Keep it in mind. Next slide. Now, the next part of this unit of instruction consists of 3 possible games. 2 at the high school that we'll talk a little bit about. Okay, we're going to actually do one of them. And a 3rd one, which we can't do because we don't have enough people to do this. But we'll talk a little bit about apples to apples. The first one we're going to do is the connection game. And in your packet, you will have 100, 200, 300, 400, or 500 point questions that deal with things that are in common with something related to suicide and suicide prevention. Let's start by teaching how the game is played. I'm going to ask any one of you, if I ask the question, king, queen, or twin, what do all of these things have in common? King, queen, or twin.
Beds.
They're all beds, absolutely. So in a normal game that doesn't deal with suicide prevention, that would probably be a 200 or 300-point question. But there are 500-point questions as well. Let me give you an example of an unrelated one that's 500 points. Let's say a garbage dump, a pair of blue jeans, and a baseball field. Seemingly unrelated things. What might they have in common?
Dugout.
Good try. Dugout might be an answer, but it's not the one I was looking for. They all have flies.
Ah.
Okay. And that would be a 500 type question. So let me give you a couple that relate to suicide and see if you might get this. If I say A, C, T, what are those three letters have in common? What would you tell me? We did go through this in our unit of instruction.
Act.
Mm-hmm. And acknowledge, care, tell. So we would be practicing that. So it could be simple letters like that. What if I said SOS? Could it be signs of suicide? Sure, it could be. So that might be one that's 200 points. Okay. So what I'm trying to get across, we could have letters. Okay. We also could have examples of giving away possessions, talking about suicide, and maybe in this case having being down in the dumps and depressed. What would they be all have in common? They're all examples of warning signs. So that might be one that's 200 or 300 points. So the game is set up in your packet to deal with these, and it's about a 10 to 15 minute review game that you could do called the connection game. Now, the other game that's in these are both in the middle school curriculum, is called the talk about game. And what you do in the talk about game is you're given a category, and you come up with as many answers as you can in a short period of time. Okay? I'm going to ask all three of you to talk about the warning signs you've heard so far in the presentation. Anybody can think of a warning sign.
Sure. Having attempted suicide at previous times.
Previous attempt.
Loss of a job.
So something, some loss.
Different feelings, helplessness, hopelessness.
Yeah. Hopefully they would go back to the issue of fact. Feelings, actions, changes, and threats. And on a checklist, there's a number of different statements that students have written down. And everyone that you respond to that you get right, you get a point. And we usually use those points as kind of extra credit on your end of the unit quiz or something of that nature. So talk about is kind of a fun activity. It actually is a popular game show in Canada called Talk About. So it's a takeoff of that. The last lesson, the game that we can't do because we just don't have enough people, is called Apples to Apples. And many of you are familiar with the game of Apples to Apples. And what I will tell you is in your unit, that's been given to you, you will have all of the pieces that you need to connect various adjectives that describe suicide issues to your unit of instruction. The one that has the best connection is the one that wins that particular game. And we usually play till you earn 3 points. So this is one that you're going to have to read carefully in terms of instructions. And I think in that case, you'll be just fine in terms of doing apples to apples. If you need to contact me, I'm more than willing to share how to play the game effectively. With that in mind, we now move to the last area, which is our assessments. We believe very strongly that there are two major types of assessments that we can be doing. Ones that are interactive and ones that are helpful after they finish the unit. And so I tried to apply those at each of the grade levels. Julie's going to talk briefly about, read her scenario and deal with the middle school one. And they have about 10 minutes to do this while the music of Mission Impossible is playing in the background. So Julie, would you read your scenario, please?
Sure.
First of all, you've blown up a balloon. Okay.
So in my small group, we have a balloon that's blown up. And inside, I'm going to take out my scenario and read it to my group. Young adults feel stress many times throughout their lives. Your task is to draw a silhouette of the sun and within it list as many ways to positively manage stress as you can. I've already done this activity here as a sample, and here are some examples that students might write. For example, they might watch a movie, play a card game, sing or swim, or go fishing.
So here's a way of kind of building on what we've talked about in the unit and going one step further towards a prevention outcome. So Mission Possible has that kind of component in it. We have one that one of the scenarios deals with warning signs. So we have different aspects of it, but it's interactive, fun, and they have to do a visual that demonstrates that. The other one that I wanted to share with you is the high school one, which is called the Crisis Card. Their document that they have to produce deals with who would they contact, in other words, tell or talk to, if they had emergency or were in a crisis. And they had to choose in three categories, and they have to develop their own little document that they would put in a purse or in a wallet, somewhere where they can address this. I said help is a phone call or an email away, and I chose that they had to do a friend or a relative in my assignment to them. So they chose Tom, best friends forever, and Aunt Sue as their two friend or relative that they would contact. They have to put down either their email or their phone number. They also had to put someone at school, some professional at school, that could make a difference as well. This particular person chose Mr. Hanson, the school counselor, and Ms. Smith, the science teacher, were the two that were most approachable. Okay. And last but not least, someone in the community, and they had to look through phone books for this, and they had to find a connection to someone their age as opposed to an adult. Dr. Roth, they saw a clinical psychologist there and said they worked with teens. And Mr. Barth, who is the youth leader at the Boys and Girls Club in their community, was the other person that this individual chose. So that's their assignment, and then they have to package it in a way that they could actually put it in a place where nobody would see it but them. So that's their two performance assessments, elementary, Mission Possible, Crisis Card, High School. Next slide, please. Well, thank you for coming to this brief overview of the curriculum today. You'll see my contact information, and we're more than willing to send you a copy of these. These are free of charge for your use. The DVDs are available at your local CESA. And if you're having trouble with that, please contact me. You have my contact information. I want to thank our participants for helping out, and have a great day.